thoughtful, progressive, enlightened, forward-looking, progressive, 21st century. If you have educated people, half of India was born after 1983. The average age of our country is 27 years. If educated people get into politics and represent the country in the parliament, policy can be implemented. We have lots of policies. We have fantastic laws. We have terrific regulatory systems. We have everything in place. We have perhaps the finest bureaucracy. But unless it's like a company that's gone sick, unless the top changes, things are not going to improve for all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, I have finished. Just one word of caution. Don't waste time. We are already too late. I'm afraid that if you don't do anything for the next 5 years, things will become irreversible. Many of my friends in the Professionals Party of India, this is a gathering of professionals. All of you are invited to visit the website, www.ppi.net.in. Many of us believe it's already too late, but I'm sure it is not. So please pass this communication on and participate and get involved and don't be afraid. It is not politics which is dirty, it is a politician that is dirty. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Krishnan. That was brilliant. Echoed my thoughts. I don't think it's just the politicians who are kind of spoiling the nation, it's the citizens who are spoiling the nation. We don't practice democracy. It's a culture of silence which prevails in the country. Every company, like how many companies do have a whistleblower policy? They don't. That's the reason Satyam happened. So I appreciate what you said and I fully agree with you. We'll have a Q&A session with you after we finish. Okay, so any questions for...
Any questions?
Yeah. Yes, Rob has a question.
Yes, please.
The insulation around the politicians.
There's a few people that I've talked to that have suggested that if there was a limit to how many years, where the self-interest doesn't have time to build. What do you think about that?
Absolutely brilliant. You're right. You said it. But who's going to do it for us? Have you all heard, Rob?
Yeah.
And there are many things like this. This is what should happen. Nobody's going to do it for us. It needs change of laws. Are they going to change laws when they are enjoying the benefits of it? No, they're not going to do it. So who's going to do it? You have to stand up, get into politics, stand for elections, sit in parliament and change the laws. I dare say those laws which are in force now have been enacted by people who've been legitimately elected. Let's not lose sight of the fact that they have been legitimately elected. You didn't participate, another matter. We are a democracy. They have been legitimately elected, legitimately put in the parliament, and they have legitimately enacted laws. If they are stupid, suffer it. But you've got to go through that process and suffer the laws. It's like a dirty street, and you are on this side of the street, and you've got the hose pipe lying that side. And you want to clean the street. You've got to go through the muck, pick up the hose, and then clean it. So go through the laws. You can't break laws. The days of civil disobedience are long gone. This is the 21st century. You can't break laws. You've got to follow the laws, follow the constitution, go through the system, and then reach there and change the laws. That's what PPI stands for. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so what do you do? I mean, what does PPI do, actually? I mean, what do you all do?
We do three things. First of all, we are not a product of an emotional outburst. That's something to be remembered, because I think we are distinctly different from everybody else. We are a product of years of research on finding solutions. And these solutions are contained in a document called the Manifesto, which I invite all of you to read. It is on the website. Now that the background is clear, we do only three things. We propagate the ideology of PPI, we raise funds for propagation, and we identify candidates for the Lok Sabha.
So do you stand for elections?
Oh yes, of course. Otherwise, the whole exercise is not useful, isn't it?
Yeah.
Of course we do. And we are of you help us find candidates, I'll be very happy. Our Bombay head is here, is Mr. Hiru Bizrani. He lives in Bombay. I come from Pune. So you can contact him, you can get his number, it's all on the website, pvi.net.in.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, please.
I read about the Professionals Party of India and I felt both good and bad. So let me cover that.
Which one first?
I felt good because, okay, there are, I don't know whether you can hear me. If you can,
yeah.
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 I felt good because there are professionals who are saying, let's get into politics, let's try and change things. Very good. And then he said, corporates don't talk politics, so let's talk politics. In my current thinking, and I could be wrong, in the Lok Sabha, it doesn't matter who you vote for, but as long as if a thinking Indian doesn't vote for either the Congress or the BJP, you're actually allowing worse dregs to come into power. Okay? It could be a Mayawati, it could be a Mulayam Singh, it could be whoever else, I don't know. Right? Any vote for the Professionals Party of India, which I would love to support, okay, until you become strong enough, I'm not sure whether I'm helping by not voting for these two major parties because they are the lesser of the evils that we are facing with. So I'm actually wondering whether a professionals group within these parties can change these two major parties, or a group like you can become strong enough to make the change that is required. So that's something that I'm not clear on.
And
I hope you understand what I'm saying.
Oh yes, I do. Oh yes. Don't worry about it. What's your name?
Anish.
Anish. Anish, which came first, chicken or the egg?
I understand what
you're saying. Okay, let me build on it. This is a good point. It has been factored into the strategy which has been developed for PPI. It has already been factored in. Leave it to us. We know this. So if we have two candidates, we will let the election pass. There's so much to be said. I don't know if I have the time and whether you have the inclination and the enthusiasm to listen to this.
Yes,
we
do.
Do?
Bless you. Thank you very much.
Yeah,
I'll tell you, Anish, what we do. We don't follow the conventional norm which political parties follow, which is give me a winning candidate and we will back him. We do just the opposite. Give us a candidate who can deliver, and our parameters of delivery are in the manifesto. The manifesto is a central document which is adapted to constituencies. That is to be delivered. If we believe that we are only going to get two candidates, we won't participate. We'll let the race go. If we have got sufficient number, we are only targeting 110 seats, by the way.
I know.
Why?
The urban seats.
Yes, we are only targeting the urban middle class who are accessible, who understand, who we can relate to, who accept the need for change, who are enlightened, they want an enlightened government, and who are not currently aligned. So we are targeting 110, 120. Our calculation is that even if half of them are there, they're a fairly sizable number. I've got the statistics to show you what percentage of votes the Congress got in 2004 elections, in the Lok Sabha elections, and what the CPM got, just for the fun of it. You all know about CPM?
Of course.
Yeah, they were supporting the government?
Yes.
Just for the fun of it, what percentage of the national votes do you think they had in 2004? Make a guess.
5%. They almost lost their national participation.
Anish is being very kind, less than 5%. 1.6%. This is the beauty of democracy. This is the beauty of our electoral system. There are 200 political parties. PPI is registered with the Election Commission. And when we went for the registration hearing, we were told there are 200 parties that participate. Look at the fragmentation, and they all target the same masses. I'm told, as a matter of policy, because we genuinely, deep in our hearts, we believe that India is going through a political, a historical evolution. Okay? So we don't blame anybody. You took a few names of politicians. I think they're just players in history. We have never been a democracy. Ladies and gentlemen, India has never been a democracy.
Pseudo monarchy.
Why pseudo? Hardcore. Hardcore. We've never been a democracy. It's a first experiment with democracy. And I think it was fair because we saw the leaders who brought us independence, that they were so highly qualified and so highly sophisticated. So the middle class of that time thought that we are in very good hands, and they pulled back. Unfortunately, what they had expected to happen did not happen, and things began to degenerate. That's not